Hello friends, today we will see the CNC part programming and predominantly the milling centers. So there are basically two types of machining centers, okay, in CNC. So if I have to classify, okay, there will be one category which is chucking center, which is also called as lathe machine center. And the other is a machining center, which is called as milling machine center. So these two categories are the predominant categories in which all the CNC machines are available. And in these two categories, mostly all type of operations are carried out on CNC machines. So we'll see step by step each of the category. And in detail, we are going to start with the machining center, that is milling machine operation. So first is a chucking center. It was developed around 1960s. Okay, it operates on two axes. Okay, x axis controls the cross motion of the turret head and z axis controls the lengthwise travel of turret head. So let's say if I have to the example of this is engine lathe. Okay, so as you can see, I have just used a pictorial representation of a lathe machine, okay, CNC lathe machine. So as you can see, on lathe machine, as we know, we work with cylindrical objects, cylindrical workpiece. Okay, so cylindrical workpiece or cylinder in particular is an axis symmetric geometry. Okay, cylinder is an axis symmetric geometry. So if I take an axis symmetric cross section, okay, axis symmetric cross section, there I mean, okay, the axis symmetric cross section of a cylinder is going to be a rectangle. Okay, now one edge, the larger edge of the rectangle, we'll say represents the central axis. Okay, and the opposite edge of that represents the outer edge. Okay, and if I try to rotate this geometry, okay, if I try to rotate this geometry about that axis, okay, what will be created? A cylinder will be created. Okay, cylinder will be created. So this two-dimensional axis symmetric section of a cylinder, okay, has basically a longer axis edge, which is what the z axis represents, and it has a the other edge which represents the radius. Okay, the other perpendicular edge represents the radius. Okay, and that is what is represented by x axis. So x axis controls the cross motion of cutting tool. Okay, x axis controls the cross motion of the cutting tool, and z axis controls the carriage travel towards or away from the headstock. Okay, so as you can see, this is a chuck, okay, where the cylindrical workpiece will be held. Okay, this is a place where the tool is going to be mounted. So now what two possible motions of this tool? Okay, now we know that lathe machine is a machine in which the workpiece rotates, okay, workpiece rotates, and the tool also moves towards and away from the workpiece. Okay, and since the workpiece is rotating, the entire cutting operation, okay, let it be facing or turning or taper turning or let's say drilling, all those operations are possible by a tool movement which is going to be along z axis and x axis. Okay, so it requires only two axes. Okay, it requires only two axes, and those are x axis and z axis, where x axis covers the radial dimension and z axis covers the length dimension of the cylindrical workpieces. Okay, so I hope this point is clear. Okay, the rotation, okay, of this chuck, okay, rotation of the chuck, here they are saying it is going to be a C dash, that is plus C dash. This is going to be a positive or clockwise rotation, you can say. Okay, so positive direction rotation is generally considered as clockwise rotation. Okay, ultimately it doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter because we have separate codes. Okay, we have separate codes for the spindle movements. Okay, spindle movements, that is in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction when we are writing the program. Okay, when we are writing the CNC programs. Okay, so it actually doesn't matter because we have separate codes for clockwise rotation and anti-clockwise rotation. So let's continue with the next machining center, that is the milling machine center, or it is also called as machining centers. So this milling machine center also developed along the same era, that is 1960s. Okay, it allows more operations to be done on part in one setup instead of moving from machine to machine. Now as we have already seen in lathe machine, okay, lathe machine, the CNC lathe can perform all the lathe operations that a manual lathe is able to perform. Okay, so that is an excellent part. On a CNC mill machine, okay, on the contrary, okay, CNC mill machine is a complete machine, you can say, and it is able to perform more operations. Okay, it is able to perform more operations, and that reduces the machine requirements, okay, of different types. So let's say generally in old eras, okay, we used to have big workshops, and there used to have big machinery which individual operators used to handle. Okay, if the workshop is running, let's say, in a double shift, okay, then those many people are required to operate the machine in both the shifts. Okay, so in that time, you would say, you would have different drilling machines, then you have milling machines, okay, then you have, let's say, shaping machines, etc., etc., as per the requirements of the operations to be carried out on different work pieces. Okay, so now what CNC mill machine does is it does operation of these 2-3 machines at a single machine. So drilling machine separately is not required. You change the tool on a milling machine, and that is what the drilling operation will be carried out. Okay, all other type of slotting, all other type of pocketing, all other type of, let's say, face milling, contour milling, okay, all types of drillings, okay, everything is possible on a single milling machine center, and that is why it can perform more operations, okay, on part in one setup instead of moving from machine to machine. So you set up a part, okay, milling machine is a machine in which workpiece remains stationary on a work table, okay, and then you have a either vertical or horizontal type milling machine. So the more famous machine is a vertical milling center. So you have tool approaching the workpiece in a vertical manner, okay, then that tool is going to rotate, and the tool is going to rotate around the stationary workpiece and carry out the machining. So that is what we understand by the milling machine. So there are two main types of machining centers in milling machine category, that is horizontal and vertical spindle. So vertical spindle, which is 3-axis milling machine, okay, is more famous, okay. So 3-axis VMC, it is in short called as, so VMC stands for vertical milling center or vertical machining center. So X-axis controls the table movement left or right, okay, Y-axis controls the table movement towards or away from column, and Z-axis controls the vertical movement of spindle or knee. Now as I am saying, the workpiece remains stationary, so while the operation is going on, workpiece is not moving. Okay, while the operation is going on, workpiece is not moving. Generally, workpiece remains stationary. Okay, there are some advanced milling machine centers in which workpiece also is made to change its position as and when it is required. Okay, so these are the this is a vertical milling center. So performs operations such as milling, drilling, gear cutting, contouring. So as I was saying, single machine can be used for multiple operations. So as you can see, this is a place where you can keep the workpiece. Okay, so it's a work table or machine table. Okay, it has XY direction. So it is a top plane. Okay, it is a top plane. Okay, as you move perpendicular to the plane in the upper direction, okay, that is the Z direction. Okay, that is the Z direction, and along that Z direction, you have your spindle. Okay, you have your spindle, and the spindle rotates about Z axis. Okay, spindle rotates about the Z axis, and then it approaches the workpiece, stationary workpiece, and it does the cutting operation. So X axis controls the table movement left or right. So this is left or right. Okay, Y axis controls the table movement towards or away from the column. So this is a vertical milling center column. So towards the column, away from column. And Z axis controls the vertical movement of knee or spindle. So as you can see, workpiece is made to come closer to the spindle is made to come closer to the workpiece. Spindle is carrying the tool, Okay, so tool will come closer to the workpiece, will perform, let's say, contour milling operation, and then go away from the workpiece. So in that way, the milling center works. This is a simple three-axis VMC. Okay, simple three-axis VMC. Now we have four-axis, five-axis, even six-axis VMCs available, which can perform literally all type of operations. Okay. So what are the basic motions? Okay, two distinct categories. One is a point-to-point motion, and the other is a continuous path motion. Okay, continuous path motion. Now these two categories are from the milling machines. Okay, categories. So these two categories are the milling machine categories. Both can be handled by most control units. Okay, knowledge of both programming methods necessary to understand what application each has in CNC. Now what happens is, okay, point-to-point and point-to-point and continuous path. So when we say point-to-point, so point-to-point operation means a drilling operation. So let's say you have a plate, and on that plate you require to carry out several drills. Okay, those drills are to be performed in following some pattern. Okay, so the geometry can be made using a feature in the 3D modeling tool, which is a linear feature or circular feature, which is basically a linear pattern drawing feature or circular pattern drawing feature. Okay, and with that feature, if we are creating the model, okay, then on a CNC machine, okay, it is a point to point operation. So the tool has to reach to a certain point at a rapid rate, okay, perform the same operation, which is drilling, okay, come up again, reach to the second drilling center rapidly, again perform the drilling, come up again, reach to the third, and this will continue. Okay, this will continue. So it is called as a point to point operation. So all the type of drilling operations, okay, all type of drilling operations are examples of this point to point operation, which is only requirement is that it has to reach the drilling center, okay, and perform the drilling operation, go to the next drilling center, okay, rapidly. So that is point to point. And continuous path operations are all milling machine operations. So you have side milling, that is contour milling, okay, then you have pocketing, then you have slotting, then you have face milling. Okay, so these are the main broad operations of the milling machines, and these are all continuous path operations. So what path tool is following is very essential. Okay, and ultimately what is the geometry that we are trying to achieve, that is also very essential. So in a continuous path operation, control has to be more precise. Okay, control has to be more precise, because all the time the tool is moving by certain calculated feed. Okay, feed and speed. Okay, and that is very essential. Okay, so the machine has to be in certain specific mode. So let's say if it is the tool is going to travel along the edge of a workpiece, which is a straight edge, then it is called as linear interpolation motion. Okay, if it is following along, let's say, a curvature, okay, then it is called as a circular interpolation motion. So circular interpolation motion can be in a clockwise direction, or it can be in anti-clockwise direction. It depends from which direction we are traversing the workpiece path. Okay, so that is called as all continuous path operation. So in point-to-point motion consists of any number of programmed points joined together by straight lines. Okay, used to accurately locate spindle or workpiece mounted on a machine table to perform the operations. Process of positioning from one coordinate, which is XY position, or location to another, perform the operation, clear tool from work, and then move to the next location. So as I explained, okay, it is following the coordinate positions. So the drilling center point, okay, the center point of a drill is a coordinate position given by XY. So tool is going to rapidly go to that point. Okay, it will be at certain height initially. Okay, so that it is not going to come in between the workpiece anywhere. So it will attain some safety height, and then it will move exactly at that workpiece at given Z height. Okay, then it will be lowered, it will touch the workpiece, spindle will start, it will perform the drilling operation, then again it will achieve some reference level in Z dimension, again move to the next XY location, continue the drilling operation, again come up to the reference level, go to the next. So that is how the point to point motion is carried out. So we are saying the drilling doesn't drilling doesn't happen when the tool is making a rapid movement on the xy plane. Okay, when the tool is making a rapid movement on the xy plane, the drilling is carried out when the tool is stationary as far as xy movement is concerned, and it is only rotating and along a predefined feed, okay, in the z direction or in the z axis. Okay, it is going to come down and go up, okay, after the drilling is performed. So that is what we call as point to point motion, okay, rapid travel. So point to point machining moves from one point to another as fast as possible, that is rapids, okay, while cutting tool above work surface. So this rapid travel is provided so that when we have let's say pattern hole drilling, okay, on a plate of let's say some 400 by 500 rectangular plate, okay, if you have to drill let's say 100 holes, okay, 100 holes of certain pattern, okay, and likewise you have let's say 500 pieces, okay, so how you are going to calculate the time requirements, okay, if you are not utilizing this rapid travel, okay, then unnecessarily the elapsed time will increase for each part, okay, and in turn that will increase the machine's time, okay, to perform the entire drilling operation. And so to reduce the unwanted elapsed time of the operations, we use the rapid travel. So when the drilling is not happening and when the XY movement of the tool is happening, okay, that movement will be carried out at a rapid rate. Okay, so accordingly we are going to change the code. Okay, accordingly we are going to change the code so the tool can move to the desired location rapidly, perform the drilling, come up, again rapidly move to the next location, perform the drilling, come up, again go to the next location, and this will continue. Okay, and this will continue. So it is used to quickly position cutting tool between location points. Okay, rate is between 200 to 800 inches per minute. So that can be the speed. Okay, that can be the speed. So it depends on what is the mechanism used in that particular CNC milling machine. Okay, but you can say 800 inches per minute is a very good speed, very good rapid speed or rapid travel velocity to have. It is going to reduce the unwanted elapsed time. Okay, both axes, that is X and Y, move simultaneously. So how the shortest path is calculated? The shortest path between two points is a straight line all the time. Okay, so X and Y movements are simultaneously done. So it is not like X is done, then Y is done, then again X is done, again Y is done. It is a simultaneous movement. So it is from one point to the second point, and it's going to be a straight line between these two points. Okay, so movement along 45 degree angle line until one axis reached, then straight line movement to other. Okay, so that is how it is achieved. Then you have the continuous path, that is contouring. It involves work produced on lathe or milling machine, where cutting tool usually is in contact with workpiece as it travels from one program point to the next program point. Okay, it has the ability to control motions on two or more machine axes simultaneously. Information in CNC program must accurately position cutting tool and follow predefined accurate path. Now, while you are following a continuous path, what is happening? The tool is rotating. Okay, tool is rotating, and at the same time it is in contact with the stationary workpiece, and by it is moving in contact, and that is how it is removing the material from the workpiece. So then you have to have a very specific program made, because what happens? Okay, the tool ideally is going to follow the line of the contour path, okay, from its center. Okay, from its center. So if it has to follow the line from its center, and if you place the center accordingly, and what happens, generally it is going to remove more material than required, okay, in a single cut, and that may affect the tool, or that may affect the finishing on the workpiece. So you have to have certain more control, okay, on the contouring path the tool is going to follow, and that is being achieved by, let's say, compensations. So you are going to compensate the movement, okay, that tool is going to make around the workpiece. Okay, if it is going to go in the counterclockwise direction, so let's say the direction the compensation is going to be on the left side, okay, or else the compensation can be on the right hand side. So all these things are very handy and they come very helpful while setting up the program and the machine. So application of some codes, if we say, so G01 is called as linear interpolation. Now we have already known that, okay, there are G codes and M codes. Okay, now G stands for general purpose preparatory codes. Okay, so from there the G is coming, and M stands for miscellaneous codes. Okay, so G codes are generally going to work with the tool motions. Okay, work with the tool motions. Okay, then they are going to work with the setting of the machine. Let's say the machine is in absolute positioning, or the machine is going to operate in incremental positioning. The machine is going to work with, let's say, inch system, or the machine is going to work with the metric system. So all this setting up of the machine, okay, setting up of the tool, then tool motions. Okay, so it is also we have to decide which is the axis, which is the plane in which the tool is going to do the to and fro motion. So that plane selection also is a G code. So G17 stands for XY plane, G18, G19 simultaneously for XZ and YZ planes. Okay, so we have to make selection over there. So in vertical milling center, normally it is G17, that is a by default code we use. Okay, then there are other settings, all the compensation settings which we have to apply. Then there are certain repetitive operations, okay, repetitive operations, which are also called as canned cycle operations. So all those operations are also carried out with the help of all these G codes. And of course you have the tool coordinates, okay, that we specify to the tool, okay, using these interpolation codes. So G01 followed by, let's say, the end coordinates where tool has to reach. So the tool is going to follow this linear interpolation. So it is going to go at a specified feed rate, okay, and reach that destination. So that is what the G01 stands for. So general format is going to be, there will be a sequence number N followed by some number G01, then XYZ location, that is the destination of the tool, and at what feed it has to reach to that destination. So a specified feed rate value. Linear interpolation results in a straight line feed move. Okay, unless tool compensation is used, the coordinates are associated with the center line of the tool. So as I said, okay, all the time by default coordinates are associated with the center line of the tool, but all the time it is not possible. As you can see, if we are following a contour milling operation, okay, the tool size is, let's say, 20 mm, okay, and if you are not using any compensation, then at a stretch 10 millimeter of material will be removed. Okay, 10 millimeter of material will be removed with the help of 20 millimeter diameter tool, okay, flat end mill, let's say. So this may be a very very large amount of material removing, okay, in a single pass, which may damage the tool, which may damage the surface finish of the workpiece. So we generally use the compensations and we try to control this. Okay, we'll see this as we go ahead in the lecture series. Okay, so as an example, for the motion that occurs in XY plane with the same maximum speed for X and Y axis, initial motion is at an angle of 45 degree to the axis until motion in one of the axis is completed, and then the balance of the motion occurs in the other axis. So this is what is called as point to point motion. Okay, let's say I have to reach this point C. So first a 45 degree motion will be carried out, so equal in both axes, and then from B to C a horizontal movement will be carried out. So positioning motion from A to C, N10, G00, okay, X30, Y20, okay, X30, Y20. So this is 30, 20 is a coordinate of point C, and currently the tool is at point A, which is 5, 5. So at feed rate, say 0, okay, at feed rate 0. So you can have any specified value. So 0, maybe this is given in inch, so 0 point something, okay. So you can have any specified value. This is just an example. These are not the actual values we have put over here. Okay. So then G01, that is linear interpolation, is also possible in lathe machines. So let's say you have the lathe center, that is chucking center, and on that also, if you have to travel along the Z axis, if you have to travel along the X axis, all these are what? All these are linear interpolations. Okay, all these are linear interpolations because the tool is going to follow a specified path, okay, specific line, okay, and that line is a straight line, okay, that line is a straight line, or that line is a slanted line, okay, but it's a line, okay, it's a line. So it is the shortest distance between the two points, and that is why this linear interpolation comes into picture. Okay, then there is circular interpolation. So G02 is a preparatory function to specify that the tool should be moved to a specific location along a circular path in a clockwise direction. So there are two codes for circular interpolation. G02 is circular interpolation clockwise. G03 is circular interpolation anti-clockwise or counterclockwise. In order to specify the path to the machine control unit, the end point of the arc and the location of the center of the arc should be specified. Within the block in which the G02 code is programmed, the center of the arc is given by specifying its location relative to the start of the arc. So let's say something of this kind. So this is G02 circular interpolation clockwise. So N followed by the line number, then G02, X2, Y1, okay, I0, J-1, and feed rate specified is at 10. So these are all in inches, you can say. So I have to reach from, let's say, this point to this point. This is circular interpolation. So the direction is going to be circular clockwise, okay, clockwise direction. So from this point to this point. So let's say from point 22 to 12 to point 21. Okay, point 12 to point 21. So what we specify, the tool is currently at this point. Okay, now it has to travel from this point to this point. Okay, it has to travel from this point to this point, and while it is traveling, it has to take a curve path. Okay, so what we specify after G code, if it's a tool moment, we specify the destination coordinate. So what is the destination coordinate? X2 Y1. Okay, X2 Y1. So this is the destination coordinate. Okay, it has to follow I0 J-1. Okay, I0 J-1. Now these are the secondary coordinates. Okay, these are the secondary coordinates which are relative to the start point. Okay, relative to the start point. Okay, so let's say secondary coordinate means what? Okay, as you can see, I0 J-1, since it's a circular interpolation, so they are talking about the radius that it has to achieve. Okay, they are talking about the radius that it has to achieve. There is another method, okay, there is another method to specify the same thing, okay, that is sequence number, then G02, X2, Y1 are the end coordinates, the coordinates of this point, and while it is going to go to that point, it is going to use this radius 1, okay, radius 1. So instead of this I0 J-1, okay, you can also give radius 1 because the radius is 1. Okay, now this I0 J-1 are the points of the coordinates of the center point. Okay, coordinates of the center point. So let's say I0 J-1. So from Y, that is the point remains, center point remains same. So J-1 actually denotes here the J coordinate was 1. From 1 to 2, the J coordinate was 1 and I coordinate was 0, and as it is coming from this point to this point, I still remains 0 and J becomes -1. Okay, J becomes -1 because from here it comes down. Okay, from here it comes down. So that is why the secondary coordinates are specified for the center of the arc as I0 J-1. Okay, I0 J-1. So there is also an example we will see. So let's say from A to B we have to go. So circular interpolation from A to B about a circle centered at C. So N10, G02, X20. Okay, X20, that is the coordinate of X coordinate of B, and Y10. Okay, Y coordinate of B. at what I 5, okay, J 15, okay, I 5, J 15, and F 25, okay, I 5, J 15, and F 25. So this is what the code looks like for the circular interpolation. In the other format, it would be a very simple, okay, than this. So I would just write N 10 G 0 to X 20 Y 10 R. Let's say 15, okay, R 15. I will only write R 15 and feed 25. Okay, so instead of specifying the center coordinates, okay, instead of specifying the center coordinates, I will only specify the radius. So that is also a simpler way of achieving this. Okay, so I hope this is understood. The next thing that we are going to see, okay, is a canned cycle operation. So our aim was to see, we have seen these two codes, basically G01, G02, and G03 also works in the similar way, but it is a counterclockwise direction. It is also a circular motion. So the next part is we are going to see the canned cycle operation. So many times what happens, we have pattern hole drillings to be performed, and in pattern hole drillings, okay, if we try to find out the coordinates of the each point, okay, and try to feed those coordinates to the program, okay, the program length will increase unnecessarily, and that will be a very, very big headache, okay, to find out these coordinates, okay, at every now and then. So instead of, we have a positioning system which is called as incremental positioning system, and using the incremental positioning system, we can easily trace the pattern with minimum number of codes, okay, or minimum number of lines, and trying to achieve that, we use a canned cycle mode. So canned cycle mode is a repetitive motion, okay, repetitive motion by changing the coordinate. So repetitiveness is what drilling operation is, a repetitiveness, and you have patterns, okay, pattern holes, okay, to be drilled, okay, and let's say circular pattern if you have, or if you have a linear pattern, okay, then you are going to change, let's say, few coordinates only. So if it's a linear pattern, let's say linear pattern along x direction, so its y coordinate is remaining fixed, okay, and you are only going to increment its x coordinate. So it is very easy to write a canned cycle program, okay, which will be having, let's say, minimum number of codes for tracing all the locations of the hole. So the sequence of some machining operations is maybe the same for any part and for any machine. For example, drilling a hole involves the following step. So positioning the tool above the point where the hole will be drilled, set the correct spindle speed, okay, feed the tool into the workpiece at a controlled feed rate to a predetermined depth, and retract the tool at a rapid rate to just above the point where the hole started. Okay, so the drilling operation, okay, has these four basic steps. Okay, what you require? You require the exact position or the exact location of the tool above the point where the drill has to be carried out. Okay, then you have to give the correct spindle speeds. Okay, then feed the tool into the workpiece at a controlled feed rate to predetermined path. Okay, so that it is going to perform the drilling. And once the drilling is done, okay, retract the tool at a rapid rate to just above the point where the hole started. Okay, so these are the repeat motions. Okay, these are the repeated motions. So these four steps should be repeated every time, okay, with a different coordinate. Okay, with a different coordinate. So that is what is achieved by the canned cycle operation. So there are different canned cycles which are commonly used on milling machines. So you have G81, that is drilling canned cycle on milling center. So down feed is a continuous feed. At bottom there is no action and retraction is rapid. G82 is a spot face or counter boring, which is also a down feed, is a continuous feed. Then at bottom there is going to be dwell and retraction is going to be rapid. So dwell means there will be nothing, okay, so it will be paused for a while and then it will be retracted. Okay, G83 is deep hole drilling, so it is down feed, is a peck, so peck is a certain depth will be achieved, the tool will be retracted, again it will be certain more depth will be achieved, again the tool will be retracted, so that is called as peg drilling. Okay, at bottom there is going to be no action and retraction every time will happen rapidly. Then you have tapping, same continuous feed, reverse spindle, okay, at bottom, and feed rate on retraction. G85, that is through boring in and out, so continuous feed. There will be no action at the bottom, and retraction is going to be the specified feed rate. And G86 is through boring, that is also happens continuous feed. At bottom, the spindle is going to stop, and while retracting, it will be a rapid retraction. So all these CAN cycle codes are used, and various pattern hole drillings, pattern hole finished drillings are achieved. And there is a code called G80 to cancel this CAN cycle mode. So CAN cycle mode, the machine immediately understands that it is going to be a repetitive motion. Okay, so then for repetitive motion, we will also change the machine positioning system to incremental mode. Okay, and then we will continue the CAN cycle. And once the all drills are drilled, okay, then we have to shift to the normal mode. So we have to cancel the CAN cycle mode, and also we have to come back to the absolute positioning. Okay, so all these things we will slowly come to know. So this is just an illustration of how the drilling is happening. So let's say N5, okay, G00, X0, Y0, Z1, okay, X0, Y0, Z1, then X1, Y1, Z0.5. So this is a reference level. Okay, so this is where it actually started, G00, X0, Y0, Z1. So it is at say set point position. Okay, from here it reached X1, Y1, Z0.5. So Z0.5 is going to be my reference position. Okay, Z0.5 is going to be my reference position. So Z0.5 means what we are saying, Z equal to 0 is my top plane. Okay, so Z equal to 0 is this top plane. Okay, this is my XY plane, cross section of the XY plane. This is my Z axis, and let's say this is my X axis. Okay, this is my X axis. So the first move establishes the Z initial plane. The Z initial plane is the height the tool is at before G81 cycle, that is 0.5 inch. It's a good idea to move the tool an intermediate distance from the part so that the less time is wasted rapiding in and out. The tool will rapidly rapid back to the initial plane after each hole is drilled. Okay, so what happens? It has to drill a hole of 0.25 mm depth. So it goes down. Okay, so this down movement, okay, is at a specified feed. So we use then N15 G81. So it's a CAN cycle mode. Z minus 0.25, R 0.125 and F5. Okay, R 0.125, F5. So when I have this CAN cycle mode, G81 on, okay, now this is going to be a single instruction. Okay, on N15, this is going to be a single instruction. So before that, it has already reached this X1, Y1. Okay, before that, it has already reached this X1, Y1. And till this, it was working with, let's say, absolute system. Okay, till this, it was working with absolute system. So then what happens is, okay, accordingly, we are going to change the Z coordinate to minus 0.25. Now here, we are not using incremental system. But while doing the actual program, we will use the incremental positioning system, and I will showcase how this is achieved. Okay, how this is achieved. So what happens is Z minus 0.25 at a specified feed rate. Okay, and R 0.125, that is happening with, let's say, at rapid mode. Okay, at rapid mode. So the tool rapids from Z initial plane to the retract plane 0.125 inch. Starting at the Z retract plane, that is 0.125 inch, the tool feeds down to the Z depth, that is minus 0.25 inch at the specified feed rate. And then the tool then rapids up to the Z initial plane, that is 0.5 inch. At this point, it would go on to the next hole. So what happens is the rapidness of the tool continues till 0.125. Then from 0.125 till minus 0.25, the drilling happens at a specified feed rate of 5 inches per minute. And then again it rapidly comes up to the 0.125, and then it goes up to 0.5. Okay, then it goes up to 0.5 rapidly. And then from 0.5, it goes to the next location. Again continue this operation, again perform the drilling, and then go to the next location. So that is what the CAN cycle mode is. So it is a repetitive motion. So motion is what? Coming down, going rapidly up, coming down, going rapidly up, coming down, going rapidly up. In between, what we do, we change the location. So one drill is performed, it comes up, it goes to the next location, it performs the drilling, rapidly comes up, goes to the next location, and this operation continues. So that is what we call as G81, that is drilling canned cycle on milling center. And the next whole drill will be achieved by only specifying, let's say, the next coordinate. So if it's a absolute system, we will specify the actual coordinate XY. If it is an incremental system, okay, we will only specify the coordinate which is changing. Okay, the coordinate which is changing. So that typically saves lot of lines. Okay, of course. So there are three main parts of CNC program. So part one is a program setup. So for that we use G codes. So that is G90, G71 basically we use instead of 21. So it is absolute programming and metric. Then M06, T020301, so stop for tool change and use tool number 2. And then M03, that is spindle on clockwise at a specified feed of 1200 rpm. Okay, then there is second part, that is chip removal, which is the actual contact of the tool with the workpiece. So let's say you use G00, that is for the rapid movement. This rapid movement is a free movement of the tool. Okay, during this rapid movement the tool is not in contact with the workpiece. So X1, Y1, it rapidly comes to the point, okay, from origin point. Then Z0.25, so it goes down, okay, it goes down to 0.125 rapidly. Okay, then G01, you have linear interpolation happening. So the Z minus 0.125 at specified feed 100 millimeters per minute. Okay, so this is achieved. Then G01 X2 Y2 feed diagonally to X2 Y2. Then G00 Z1 rapidly come up to Z1. Okay, then rapidly go to let's say X0 Y0 and so on. So this is a chip removal operation. Okay, where all G codes we are using. And as I said, for the tool position, okay, tool position, we use these linear and circular interpolation G codes. And at the end, there will be system shutdown. So M05, that is turn off the spindle. Okay, similarly, M09 is to switch off the coolant supply. And also M00 or M30 is the program stop and rewind. Okay, so all these operations are basically divided into three main parts. So part one is a program setup. Then part two is a chip removal, where actual tool is in contact with the workpiece and doing the cutting operation. And then the when the cutting operation is done, we are slowly switching off the machine. So you have few miscellaneous cores, okay, coming into picture, and turning off the spindle, turning off the coolant supply, and stopping the program. Okay, so I hope this is understood. Okay, in the next lecture we will actually do a drilling program. So I will display the diagram, okay, where the positions of the drills are mentioned. The workpiece thickness is also given. Okay, probably material is known to us and feeds and speeds are also known to us. What we have to do? We have to write a manual part program, okay, using whatever we have just seen. Okay, so we probably also write a simple drill program, and then we will also write a canned cycle program. Okay, canned cycle program. And there I will showcase how all other G codes and M codes are to be used. Okay, so I hope you have liked this lecture. Okay, if you really like this lecture, please hit the like button. Also, please share the videos and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.